coming up right now, there is no better person to welcome all of you here tonight. None other than the father of our bride. So please, one more time, put your hands together for Mr. Bill Burns.
First and foremost, Annette and I would like to thank each and every one of you for sharing this very special day with Billy and Stephanie. To be very honest with you, this is not the toast I planned on giving tonight. I could not give the toast that I planned on because I knew I would never finish it. I would get too emotional, and you wouldn't understand me if I'm standing up here crying. So, basically, I'm going to just tell you a story. September 22nd, 6 years ago. Now, I know you heard this. You heard part of this at church tonight, okay? But Billy and Kristen came home. Our son and his wife came home from Nicaragua. We wanted to take him out to celebrate his birthday. We went to a very nice restaurant in Burlingame that my daughter recommended. And when the hostess took us to our table, my daughter asked the hostess, "Would you mind if we sit outside on the patio tonight?" I happened to look at my daughter and say, "Steph, we have a party of eight. I don't know if they can, you know, accommodate us on the patio." Fortunately for us, they were able to do that, and we ended up sitting on the patio. And the reason I bring that up is, if they could not accommodate us on the patio, we probably would not be here today, okay? So we're sitting on the patio, and Billy Wien comes up to take our cocktail order. You're going to hear a lot of Billy Wing and Billy B tonight, because we have to separate them, because when the family's together, my siblings call me Billy. My son is Billy. My son-in-law is Billy. So we have certain names. This is Billy Wing. My son is Billy B. And I just answered to Billy. But Billy Wing came up to our table to take our order, and my wife happened to say to him, "Excuse me. We're here celebrating our son's birthday," meaning Billy B. And Billy Wing says, "My wife said we're here to celebrate our son's Billy's birthday." And our waiter, our server said, "Oh, my name is Billy." And then he says, "Is today his birthday?" And we said, "No, actually his birthday is September the 1st. My wife said to Billy Wing, "Well, my son's birthday is also September the 1st. Needless to say, he was basically the topic of our conversation that night. You know, and the people in the party said, "Oh my God, he's so friendly. You know, he's very..." Is this better? Okay. I apologize. So everybody at the table is saying, "Oh, Stephanie, this waiter is so friendly and charming." And you know how the women say, "Easy on the eyes." So, you know, we had dinner. We had a great evening. And during dinner, I heard my daughter say, "God, I wouldn't mind knowing him a little better." Well, me being her father, I excused myself from the table on the pretense I had to go to the restroom. So I walked to the restaurant, and I ran into this young man. And I gave him Stephanie's phone number. And I said to him, "Give her a call sometime." Now, would I normally do this? Not in a million frickin' years, okay? But I did it for two reasons that night. One, my daughter said I wouldn't mind knowing him a little better. And two, whenever he came to our table, he paid much more attention to Stephanie than he did the rest of us. So I was like trying to play Cupid. So I was trying to play Cupid. So after dinner, we leave the restaurant. We're standing out in front of the sidewalk. And two or three people in our party said, Steph, you have to go in there and give them your phone number. And you can actually tell Stephanie was actually thinking about it. So her brother Billy says, I will go in and give him your phone number. Fortunately, Stephanie said yes, okay? But I left because I went to get the car. So I had no idea what transpired. So Billy B went and gave Billy Wing Stephanie's phone number. Billy Wing happened to say, oh, your dad already gave it to me. Billy B goes back out and tells Stephanie, oh, dad gave it to him. So we leave the restaurant, we're in the car, we're driving back to San Jose, and my daughter says to me, hey, dad, did you give the server my phone number? Me, not wanting to lie to my daughter, I said, Steph, why would I do that? Okay, big mistake on my part. She totally reamed me out, and she didn't talk to me for 2 days. And the reason I share that with you tonight is September 22nd, which was 3 months ago, I get a text from my daughter. Excuse me, guys. Oh, I have one. I brought my own. Actually, it's a washcloth from my room. It's much more exorbitant than Bounty towels. So she says to me, you know, she was upset that I gave her phone number away and she didn't talk to me for a couple of days. And so I get a text from her on September 22nd of this year, and she goes, Dad, thank you for giving my phone number to Billy Wing. I read that toast, and I got very teary-eyed. But I texted her back, and I said, Stephanie, years ago, there was a program on TV, and it was called Father Knows Best. Honey, I love you more than Duncan Pill. But what I really want to say, you know, this is very hard for me, only because I was blessed. I was seriously blessed to have a father-daughter relationship, a father-daughter bond with my daughter. And for that, I am forever grateful. That makes it a little hard for me to stand up here. But let's get back to the toast. What I want to do is I want to thank Stephanie for giving me the opportunity to give this toast without embarrassing myself. There's some people laughing because they know what I'm going to say next. Whenever I discuss my children, it's always Billy and Stephanie, Stephanie and Billy, and just they go hand in hand. Well, when I gave the toast at my son's wedding to Billy and Kristen, I inadvertently called Kristen Stephanie. And I didn't even realize it until everybody in the room started laughing. I was so embarrassed, I wanted to die. So Stephanie, thank you for marrying a Billy. Okay? You made this toast very easy for me. But what I really want to say is, Stephanie, I have so many fond memories of you that I will cherish for the rest of my life. Coaching your little league team, going camping, going to 49er games, going to Giant games, our special father-daughter dances at school. But in particular, I have great memories of you working at our cafe. This young lady, was 10, 11 years old, and she'd be standing on a milk carton at the counter during the height of lunch, and she'd be reading her customers, running the register, giving change, and I would stand there and I'd be in awe of her, because we actually had two or three adult employees. Kika, you can attest to this. You know, we had two or three adult employees that could not run the register at the height of our busiest time because they'd have a panic attack knowing there was 150, 200 people in line. But Stephanie, when you did it, and I would sit back and watch you and I'd be in awe because you were flawless. You did a great job. I've known Billy Wing for 6 years. I think I know him pretty well. And there's no doubt in my mind, he'll be a great husband and a fantastic father. But not only that, you're going to inherit, if I may steal a line from Top Gun, you're going to inherit a hell of a wingman. Okay. Billy Wing, from the day she was born, I've called her my star. I don't think there's 10 people in this room that have ever heard me utter those words. It was pretty much just in-house. But over the years, I have loved, cherished, and occasionally spoiled my star. Okay? Stephanie is now your star to love, cherish, and occasionally spoil. The key word, occasionally. Okay? Billy Wing and I are proud to call you our son. And welcome to our family. Billy B, you now have another brother, okay? Love you both more than tongue can tell. Thank you for putting up with me. Thank you.
Thank you. Let's give one more big round of applause to our bride's father. And with that, we're going to continue on with our meal service. Feel free to keep eating. We'll bring up the rest of our toasts a little bit later.
There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions in my heart, like why are we here and where do we go, and how come we're so hard. It's not always easy and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together.